to roll out the same. We'll be formulating strategies on how to roll out the same and to come over the problem. The entire 1.5 hour session will be revolving around this 2 hours of development and consulting. I think, first of all, I would like to invite Mr. Jitendra Kumar. He has around 15 years of experience. He's a past student from our PGDRDN. Obviously, the past year students are the trained setters for all other batches. Many congratulations from our side, Jitendra Kumar. And I think the entire session and the fellow students from NIRT of this batch, they'll be anticipating certain things. And in this context, I am throwing lights on certain questions. I think it would be better for you to throw lights on the entire things. Mr. Jitendra Kumar, first of all, my questions would be, how do you define development consulting? And this is the primary focus we should emphasize upon. My second thing would be obviously the existing and potential opportunities in development sector, my current scenario, basically in national and state context. And far more issue will be the scope of growth. How a fresher to improve upon and to reach different positions to take up, to shoulder bigger responsibilities in near future. Last but not the least, the challenges we do encounter in our day-to-day managing consulting issues. I think in the context of all these questions, you may throw some lights to our fellow students. Mr. Jitendra Kumar.
So, thank you, Gyanji, and thank you, Jaina, for introducing. I hope I am audible.
Yes, perfectly.
Yeah. So, Mr. Jan has asked 4 or 5 questions at the same time. So I believe that I will take those questions partly one by one, and I will also request my fellow panelists to contribute on each questions instead of answering in sequential manner. So very first thing, as Jana has mentioned, that I have some 10 to 15 years experience in the development sector or in this field. So 1 or 2 sentences about myself, I worked with the NIRD, so that was government setup job. Then I worked in the corporate sector, few project implementing agency, and now hardcore consultancy with the Grant Thornton. So I will say my most of the work is with respect to the rural development area. So instead of those marketing, sales, or other activities, so I remain focused on the development sector. So very first thing, the first question by the Jana was how I look at the development consultancy. So for all those, the participants and the joinee, first I will explain, or in the sense means from the consultancy point of view, most of the big organizations, those who provide, say, the private sector and public sector consultancy. So I will just mention the few upcoming organizations, they have very much one focus. They are the public sector consultancy, mostly in the development sector. But few big organizations, they provide both services for the private sector clients, whom the clients are private, or say the industry people, they provide auditing and some other services. And public sector consultancy, this particular nomenclature comes when our clients are governments. So different ministries and state government, so those departments, whenever a consultancy firm is providing services, those services is called the public sector consultancy. Now, under the public sector consultancy, certain tasks or certain assignments are specifically termed as the development consultancy. Overall, there are some other areas as well. I will just give example from the Grant Thornton's perspective. So we provide some, say, the infrastructure related. Even the client is government, that is a public sector consultancy. So the infrastructure projects, some sports consultancy, they are not specifically for the development. But whenever our clients and our assignments is having livelihood component, we are having the skill development component, we are having agriculture sector in which we are focusing on, you know, the upliftment of, I will say, the rural areas in terms of employment generation, in terms of poverty alleviation, in terms of educational aspect. So those are the areas are termed as the development consultancy. So we, like our firm is providing these type of services. So with respect to the first question, what is the development consultancy? I will also ask the fellow panelists if they wanted to add upon any points on this thing. So they can add up certain one or two liners or sentences, then we can go for the second question's reply. Anything, Arnav, Abhishek, Shikha?
Thank you, Jiten sir. I think you have very well defined this concept of development consulting. I mean, whatever we would be saying, we would be repeating the same thing. If there is someone who has some different idea to focus on to, you know, say here, they can. Otherwise, we can move.
Okay. So now we have the second question as said by the Jenna, like what are the opportunities in the development consulting? So if from the consultancy point of view, and for very layman, if I wanted to introduce the job related opportunities available, so I will say any consultancy firms try to hire the professional at two level. The very first level, whenever they bid, they put a bid at some client level. At that time, they collect your CV and they just set certain terms and conditions that if we are getting, we are winning this particular bid, we will be hiring you, we will be taking your services. Second job arises when any consultancy firm is already having certain assignments, but in the midterm, they like some of their professionals either resign or move out to other things. So at that time, they used to hire professionals. So at these two occasions, mainly consultants are hired, or I will say the professionals are hired on the consultancy firm. And third can be those roles are very limited. Those are called the retainers. Like the, they require some professional services for a limited period, say the 2 months or 4 months, and the particular salary component is discussed. So these are the three types of role provided. And very briefly, I will just also mention. So consultancy provides sometimes the full-time employees as well as the, say the limited term employment, and more or less their conditions are similar, but there is a only difference is the duration of this thing. And now coming to the very basic questions, what are the opportunities? If I say the PGDRDM's perspective, our opportunities and the area of expertise which we develop during the PGDRDM courses, so the areas are, I will say, the very wide. There are multiple sector on the basis of your, you know, expertise. Last 2 months, that one elective courses, you can go on different sectors. But one limitation is that after getting out of the PGDRDM, you need to have certain experience, because experience is much valued. And whenever we take assignment from certain clients, we promises that we will be providing certain professional with this much of experience in this field. So I suggest, so means like always have certain experience, different set of experience that are required. And my fellow analyst will also mention this thing.
I would like to add here. Thank you, Jiten, sir. Actually, I have mentioned it very clearly that what are the requirements in the consulting field. What's is there, the when we have a RFP or the agreement from a public from government side or a public agreement, so they ask for a 5 years experience. But you know what, in today, in present time, we have a good opportunity where they are asked, I mean, like small companies are coming up, like small consultancy firms, they are also hiring freshers in different areas. You know, we are as an NIRDians, we have a, you know, a good understanding of rural world, rural development or rural world. So we have a huge opportunities. Like we can work in an agriculture sector, we can work in a skill development sector. Then we also have an opportunity to work in an MSME development sector. So likewise, I just want to add here, it's not about that if anyone have a 5 years experience or six years experience, then only he can come in a consultancy firm. But those who are freshers or who are recently completing PGDRDM courses, they are also welcome in these fields, because few organizations like ALC is there, then the other small Quest Corp is there, who are hiring the consultants for, in less experience. So thank you. I want to add only this much from my side.
Yeah, Abhishek and Arunabh, please.
And definitely what Jitendra sir said is perfectly correct, but hiring mostly depends on the requirement of the client in consulting sector. In government and public sector clients, generally the tendency for recruitment is what they ask is minimum of 2 years of experience, can go up to 5 years of experience as a minimum. So that is what even the consulting agencies are bound to give such people. So eventually they end up hiring people who have at least a minimum of 2 to 5 years of experience. So not an issue. If you're looking at, especially for the freshers, if you're looking at a consulting sector to build your career in consulting, definitely you can prepare for it. Go and work in the industry for a couple of years, 3 years, 4 years, then join the sector. That would be good for you also. शुरुआत से ही कंसल्टिंग में जाके कोई मीनिंग है नहीं. पहले इंडस्ट्री का सेक्टोरल नॉलेज और डोमेन नॉलेज क्रिएट करने के बाद वंस यू गो टू द कंसल्टिंग इंडस्ट्री या यू आर रियली वैल्यूड.
या अभिषेक.
या थैंक यू जितेंद्र सर एंड आई अप्रिशिएट एवरीवन्स व्यूज ऑन दिस. So as Jitendra very rightly mentioned, what are the different channels through which actually someone can enter this consulting world? So I would also reiterate that and saying that there are public tenders. So in public tenders, there are very clear cut guidelines on what are the requirements of resources. They lay it out like that in terms of numbers of years of experience, what all experience they want. So that is one thing. The other thing is obviously at any stage of and any assignment that there is a requirement of certain resources. So at that time, what an organization will do, that organization will open it. Mostly they open it through their internal references, that they will open it for their FTEs, which are full-time employees, so that they can get it easily and in short period of time. So if I talk about PricewaterhouseCoopers, then there are three modalities through which a consultant is usually hired. The first one obviously is FTE, which are full-time employees. These days, these are a bit challenging because then there is, there is culture of JBRs. If you have heard that there is joint business relationship kind of thing, which is coming up. Initially, what a consulting firm is doing that they would like to hire someone at JBR level. So that would be a project-based contract. So it depends whether they would like to confirm you depending on your performance or depending on the requirement in future. And there is another like FTC, which is a fixed term contract, which is almost similar to FTEs. Am I audible?
Very much.
Yeah. So these are the three areas through which a consultant can enter into it. Then some of my colleagues have also mentioned that what are the different consulting areas, like there is agri, there are MSMEs, there are skill and livelihood. So moving forward, we would also like to understand from each one of us that what are the different skill sets which are actually required. It's fine that someone can enter through these routes, but what are the actually skill sets required? And the skill set obviously varies at different levels. Like if we try to enter at managerial level, so there are different skill sets required. If we try to enter at senior consultant level, there are different skill sets level required. So for this, it is from my side. I would like to move forward.
Thanks.
I think your voice is breaking, Jitendra sir.
Okay, thanks Abhishek. I hope it's clear now.
Yeah.
See, whatever the Abhishek and the other gentlemen and the Shikha mentioned, there is a very interesting point I recalled recently. See, when I was at very early stage of my career, before joining any organization or when I was preparing for many interviews, I used to see, the credentials of the organizations. And then I followed and tried to had certain to come up or just join only the good organization. Now, as an, I will say, the active member of my GTE organization, it is my responsibility, I used to hire many resource person on different assignments. Like I have hired here some 25 resource person for the Uttar Pradesh Skill Development Mission. And one thing which I realized right now, why it is very important to choose the first few organizations, because our assignments require, we promise integrity to our clients. So whenever I used to see the CV and I find out certain agencies or say the project implementing agencies whose views are their credentials are not good, I inherently feel reluctant to hire individuals from them. There are many PIAs which are having bad names in the market. So for all the newcomers and those who are going to join certain organization, please be very careful, because your association, if it is just for good package or, I know this thing, because they will give you anything, say a handsome amount. But sometimes they expect certain way of functioning, which is not appropriate, not integrated. Integrity is questioned. Like you have to forge the number if you are working in the project implementing agency of the some skill development programs. But they hampers your potential in getting into some big organization, because big organization or any established organization, they are very much cautious to hire individuals with very clean credentials. So if you develop reputation and respect whatever the firm you are working currently, then it will, I will say, the incrementally rewarded at the time of joining any consultancy firm. So this is my one of the advice. Firstly, you are not coming in the consultancy firm, but wherever you are working or you're planning to switch upon, please give package secondary importance. First is the its importance, credential in the market. In the long run, it will help you in a grand manner. So that's the one point which I added. And then moving out to the next question, and that is like the specific, there is a question called this scope for learning.
Yes, scope for learning.
Scope for learning, creating impact and growth in development consulting. So I will ask Abhishek or Arnav to take up this question. I will be adding up on this thing. Shikha, please go on this question itself. Arnav?
Yeah, thank you, Jitin, sir. As I mentioned earlier, actually, I would like to say something about a skill set first. The more you work in with government sector, more there are the chances that you will work very well in a consulting fields, because there are in every company, whether it's a EY, GT or KPMG, we have a particular vertical for government sector. And you know what, there we have a same thing like we do, like I worked in a Rurban. So in Rurban, my responsibilities are like to meet, to listening with the director and the other stakeholders and to prepare report. The same thing we have to do in these fields. But you know what's my mistake? I left Rurban in a 1.5 year and then I joined KPMG. So I find a bit difficult, suddenly come from a rural background then to the corporate background. So it's a, my request that those who are working in a government sector right now or those who are getting a placement from NIIT, please be stay there at least for 2 to 3 years, that you will get the understanding. You know what happened when I was there? I was just like, yaar, ye to kuch sikhate hi nahi hai. Hame sirf file uthane ke liye kehte hain, noting banane ke liye kehte hain, letters likhne ke liye bolte hain. You know what? The same thing we have to do now in either it's a KPMG or whatever, it's a consulting firm. But the same thing is happening. So be perfect on those times only. You know, in any company, there are only 3 requirements where we need to work. One is the report articulation. We all know that, I remember the first class of Murali sir, when he asked us to do only 3 things. First, river of life. Second, you just read 1 paragraph daily and do articulation. And I promise, humme se koi nahi karta wo cheez. And the third thing is to write a book on yourself. A book is like an assignment, so we have to do. The first is a river of life, because the sir hamesha check karte hai, and he used to discuss with us what is your river life and everything. But the second point we always miss. So again, it's a request that please do that thing in your college itself, so that you will not get a difficulty to do while you are in job. You know, now I'm pursuing MBA from NMIMS, Narsimhanji. So, you know, there what happens when they give assignment, it's not like that you can copy paste from Google or anything. They are asking to write each question of a 1000 words, and they do check plagiarism. Plagiarism is a methodology, or you can say the test where you cannot copy paste from any of the Google website or any from of the book. They will check through a different softwares, and they will put either they will give you 0 or they will give you good marks. So that's the criteria. I know this criteria is not in our NIID. That is again a good thing, but at the same time we need to focus in this in this skill set where we have to learn how to make reports, not just in a Word document, but in a good format where we have to see font size, font style, boundary, alignment, everything we need to see. And the second and the third thing is the PowerPoint and Excel. You should be a proficient. It's not about consulting firm, but in anywhere you will go, they will ask only these 3 things from you. You should know Google, you should know PowerPoint, Word, and Excel. And in Excel also, now I'm telling you my experience. One of my friend asked me to do some Excel functions. When I saw those assignments, it was an interview of his. And when I saw all those questions, all those are of advanced function. What advanced function? They asked him to make a report through pivot table, a kind of a dashboard. And the second thing they asked, nested if. It was easy, but it was a nested if. And the third one, they asked to make him report through Goalseek. Goalseek is a one method in a Excel. So these are the things where I think we have to really see ourselves where we are lacking behind or how we can improve this. Because in every area, these 3 things are, hardcore skills for ourselves or hardcore skill set for ourselves. And the second question, sir has asked about scope of learning. So scope of learning is always be there. It doesn't matter where you are. Like I'm a consultant. Again, I have a very scope of learning. I'm getting new things to learn. Like if I speak about a skill set, there are the many things which we need to learn. When I say it's a PowerPoint, it's not about a PowerPoint. Then we have to be a storyboarding thing. You know what is a storyboarding? Storyboarding is when you make a presentation, it should be a story kind of thing, where the each point of yours is interlinked with each other, and it's kind of a story. When we say some story like 2 children's. The second thing. We should also learn in our current jobs a bit of work in policy formulation and policy implementation. Implementation work we always do. But sometimes, our seniors or our higher authorities would ask us to make some SOPs or some rules or regulation for their own company or for some project. So those things also you should keep in yourself, because this would help you in a consultancy firms. So thank you, sir. Arnav, sir, you would like to add something?
Yeah, just adding to your and Jitendra sir's points. Yeah, definitely. PowerPoint presentation is something which you cannot avoid. Raat ko 2 baje bhi call aa jata hai, I need a presentation by tomorrow morning 6. You have to deliver. Clients are as such. Matlab, most of us work with clients who are at least of principal secretary or probably head of the department, secretary level. And you cannot refuse them generally. So PowerPoint, you have to be impeccable. Excel sheets, yes, lot of things you do. Matlab, jitne bhi reports wagera banate ho, lot of analysis is required. So obviously Excel has to be there. And see, consulting, matlab, in loose words, consulting 20-30% is about smart copy paste. Huh? So bahut log ye mistake karte hain ki copy paste karne ke time wo smartness chala jata hai. That is something matlab, has to be learned during their education time itself. So that's it probably.
Yeah, correct.
Learning, definitely, any of the consulting industry, be it KPMG, EY, PwC, GT, anybody, lot of emphasis is given on job learning. So all of us have to go through a mandatory learning of at least 30 hours in a month. So it is, I believe, Shikha, it's there in your organization as well, right?
Yes, sir, we have.
So a lot of mandatory learning and across all levels, not only ki shuruaat mein hi ho raha hai. I have seen partners doing trainings.
It's okay. I'm intervening here. Actually, looking to the time constraints and the students speak many things also, they have some curiosity. My obvious question to the panel. Yes, many of the students have faced us, and hardly will be getting students of up to 2-3 years of experience pursuing their study in NIRD. My question in this context, how do you suggest, my question is to the entire panel, how do we suggest a kind of methodology, kind of approaches to groom the students to fit into the consultancy arena? That's the first thing, because whenever they are entering into a maximum of the students are being absorbed by SRLM. If this is the scenario, what do you suggest? What kind of strategies they should follow to at least make them ready for consulting kind of business?
Gyana sir, if I can take it forward.
Yes, no issue.
So Gyana sir, to understand that what skill sets are actually required.
Not to me, it's to the entire audience.
Yeah, not to you, but to the entire team there. Yes. So to understand what skill sets are actually required to enter and then survive and then grow in a consulting world, we actually need to have a very crystal clear clarity on what is the nature of work that is being taken in consulting world. So it has been highlighted by other speakers at different points of time.
I'm not saying about consulting. I'm saying the maximum of the students are being absorbed by SRLMs. And during this 2-3 years of period of young professional or any other role, what kind of things they should follow? What Sikha was just reiterating the same thing, be it river of life, be it writing on yourself, or the key thing is how to articulate the kind of thing. My question would be obvious, what are the specific strategies our students need to follow so that they will be one point of time improving upon the particular skill and fit into the consulting arena.
Yeah, Jan, quickly I would like to respond to this. There are three things they can do: join SRLMs or any other PMUs or project implementing agencies. Domain knowledge thoro hona chahiye 2-3 saal mein. Technical skills. Either MS Office कह लो या probably मतलब data mining and all अच्छा होना चाहिए, and do lot of advocacy for consulting industry to come into this sector, you will be hired.
I would like to add here. Actually, while they were on field visits, because SRLM provides them a very good field exposure. So at that time, what they can do, whenever they do some field visit, they could write it on a paper. Or even if they need a help, they can post it in Abhivyakti or they can mail any of us. So that what we can help them, we will review it. And if anything is lacking there, so at that time, we can tell them, okay, these are the few things which we need, you need to improve. So this is the one thing where they can find this method for their improvement. And the second, they visit few departments. For example, if they visited education department or any skill development department, or they are working in DDU-GKY. So they can make a presentation of DDU-GKY. You know, these are the what I was, the things which I'm telling are the questions when any consulting firm or the managers were asking during the interview to make all those things. One of like in DDU-GKY, they can make a presentation, they can do a SWOT analysis of it, or they can prepare a write-up on DDU-GKY. So these are the small things that while on the field or while on any office, the students or the our colleagues can do.
Yeah, so there are a few other pointers, I will say the practical things I would like to add here. Very first thing, those individuals who have just completed only the 1 year assignment, please get enrolled in some correspondence, 2 year course, complete it right away. That's the very first thing. Second, everyone should be having a good connect with their seniors and to understand the CV writing, because many guys, I know our juniors, my immediate juniors and the team members, like the they have good experience. They have done so much work, but whenever you see their CVs, it's not reflecting there. Only I know some good friends of mine. I know their work. They have done so much things, but when I used to see their CV, they have not properly presented there. Then I used to add those points from my side and then make their CV robust so that it can be accepted by the client. So a good CV that should be elaborated. You can always take you can interact with your seniors, like what are the pointers should be there, what are the like the catchy words seen by the organizations as well as the clients. And third thing, please place your CV in their network. Like I used to reach out many say juniors and in the alumni group also to hire. And whenever opportunities are there in the GT. So if I already have certain CVs, then I feel free to pass it on to my other colleagues. Because if somebody is required, just one individual, I don't put it in the group. If I have that CV with me, I used to pass it on. So you just try to provide your CV to your respected or your admired agencies, seniors, so that they can utilize it. So these two, three things are very handy, practical things you can do. And another thing is that please do the best job which you are doing at your any other organization and keep it updating in your CV and remain in constant connect with the individuals who are working in the consultancy. These are going to help you in your first step in any good organization or the consultancy firm.
So I think most
exactly,
of the points
exactly Jitendra had a very good point. But most of the jobs these days, at least a minimum of 70% of jobs in consulting sector is through personal networks. So it's very important make friends in the consulting industry. But sabse bada point yehi hai, achhe dost banao consulting industry mein if you want to get into consulting.
Okay, this point of time before from class 14, the other question. You please go ahead.
Hi everyone. So I'm Vipul from batch 14. So with respect to CV, I just had a thought. Why can't we have a common pattern or a template for CV, which can be circulated amongst all of us? And as alumni, can we maintain a database of our CVs, and we are free to alter our CV as well, but this would help. Yeah, hello.
That's true. CV pattern is cannot be put in a compartmental kind of things. Suppose form A follow a different kind of format and form B is also having different. But what Jendral Kumar is suggesting, ki at least whatever things we are learning and whatever things we are working upon, we need to highlight in such a way, be it with different format, but that things should come in crystal. That's the thing.
My idea of putting this forward was one pointer was to gather our own database, in the form of a one pager CV, so that if anyone comes to for reference or for some so we can quickly at least have an overview.
Yeah, we've also just one thing. In fact, we have taken your suggestion. We are noting it down. Yesterday, we have discussed that our Abhivyakti team is coming up with certain masterclass sessions in which they are having some very, the attractive and interesting plans in upcoming days. So they will definitely have some 45 minutes or in a 1 hour session, what things should be there in the CV. And at present, all the organization and majority of the client follow World Bank format. So we can always provide you that format. So you can have that ready. And that can be taken up. Abhivyakti will definitely look into this thing. They will be having certain session in which CV can be explained, like they are planning something related to PowerPoint. So we are we appreciate your point. Next question.
Yeah. Thank you. So one more second point was I wanted to talk was second point was can we come up with a quarterly coffee table regarding this idea is regarding putting up our field experiments or something, because our Abhivyakti magazine is definitely going to continue, but if a quarterly coffee table wherein a 30 or 40 pager product can be come up where like Shika and others were mentioning, short write-ups from the fields can be used. Just like what Irma and other people do, they are good at branding on that. So if we can do that, I think it would be a strong pillar for us too.
Yes, we'll take it.
Coffee table means PowerPoint banao.
Sorry?
Coffee table nahi, PowerPoint presentation banao uspe, compile PPT, which is more easily shareable digitally.
The idea was to
come up with some idea is great.
People, I want to say that your idea is great, and we have in Abhivyakti team we already had a discussion on this, so we are maybe in couple of months we are going to come up with such ideas.
Because in magazine, it's like a full-fledged article. So it generally takes a lot of review and a lot of back-end work involved in that. So coffee table can be more of a simpler version. Just like quick drop-in.
Okay.
Because that would help us to be updated in our field. Right?
So, Vipul, now I will request other participants. So please ask question related to our current topic. And you can ask from our personal experience or anything as those things, because I can see certain points we still need to elaborate, but we request you to be interactive.
In this broad context, exactly basic things I think we need to cover. One is the challenges part, because when our students are joining with a particular organization, in initial few days, take it as 3 to 6 months, all of us do fumble in different kind of things. Suppose it's a drafting, because if you go by the drafting of one organization to other, obviously the pattern varies. But the key issue is regarding drafting, regarding oil movement, regarding some immersion kind of things in the villages or rural areas. I think, how do you suggest, how our students make a cop-up strategy to overcome the entire thing? That's my question to the all panelists. That's the key issue, because many of the students, they are also leaving the assignments in midway and without any having a logical outcome.
So if I understand correctly, I don't feel this is a challenge. This is a real challenge because see, there is a no. I think, can you please mute? Okay. So there is a no going back to the work. Yaar. Matlab, काम है काम से तो बच के आप वो चैलेंज नहीं है लाइक इफ यू डोंट नो द पावर पॉइंट हाउ टू प्रिपेयर अ गुड पावर पॉइंट एंड यू आर नॉट रेडी टू वर्क वर्क रिलेटेड थिंग देयर इज अ नो एक्सक्यूज एंड देयर इज अ नो रेमेडी द ट्रेडिशनल रेमेडी कि आपको थोड़ा जितनी कल मेहनत की थी उतने से आज ज़्यादा मेहनत करना है अपने सीनियर से आपको सजेशंस लेने हैं जूनियर के साथ टीम बिल्डिंग करनी है काम करना है So like if you feel any challenges related to work, you have to adjust it. And the only thing which can be handy is your commitment and enthusiasm and your, you know, admiration for the growth or whatever you wanted to do or make a name in the consultancy field. But there are a few other challenges. Means like how to handle the client or how to get those things like you are having stress or so much work in the limited time there can be certain things which are real challenges but like handling the client is one of the biggest challenge stress like so much work in the given period can be the another challenge but you know if you are not able to do the task or you are let's say if you want to you're not good at in any excel or powerpoint you have to learn it You have to put extra effort to understand that. With respect to the client-related challenges, I will suggest there are soft skill is the only way out because we have mentioned so many things about the technical skills. Consultancy is all about the people's relationship. In salesman or marketing, we used to say that customer is the king, but in consultancy, client is the king. For your like for everybody's reference and. I will just like to mention, even if you are a very good resource person to the firm, but if your client do not appreciate you, your immediate boss will think twice to have you for the next 6 months or 1 year. He looks at your performance from the client's point of view. So I will just anytime like we can have that discussion. You should be very much people-oriented person. You should be developing interpersonal skills. You should be able to gauge the requirement from the client, your immediate interaction. Because in the consultancy field, hardly some 20 or 30% of time you are working with your colleague only, like within a office atmosphere. Sometimes 70% in the development sector, 75 to 80% time you are on field with the client or with the beneficiaries or the second level जो स्टेकहोल्डर्स होते हैं उनके साथ में सो इंटरपर्सनल स्किल्स यू मोस्ट ऑफ यू नो देयर इज अ लिस्ट ऑफ दोस थिंग्स प्रॉपर कम्युनिकेशन गुड लाइक द फॉर्मल कम्युनिकेशन एज वेल एज द वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन कम्स इंग्लिश इज वेरी मच इम्पॉर्टेंट इन द आई विल से व्हेन यू आर वर्किंग विद द सेक्रेटरी और दैट लेवल बट एट द लोकल लेवल आवर लोकल लैंग्वेज इज रिक्वायर्ड So I was just touching upon this aspect of challenges. Of course, my other panelists would also mention the challenges in the development sector and resolution as well.
Agree to all the points, Jitendra sir. Very well.
Yes, Abhishek. Please. Abhishek, please go ahead. Hello.
Hello,
Abhishek.
So, am I audible now?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, agree to what Jitendra sir said, very rightly said. So, if we look at the challenges, they obviously are challenges, but then they are the road to our growth also. So, like everyone now has a fair idea that we deal with government clients. And so, while dealing with government clients, we report to top-notch bureaucrats there. So then the expectation is like that you should be very technically sound. You should have very good reporting and writing skills. That are all the requirements. So that is one challenge. the other side of consulting world, we all need to understand is that everyone, wherever they are at different stages, whether they are consultant, whether they are senior consultant or manager level, they are supposed to work on not single project. They are always on multiple projects. So if I'm handling a PMU project, I would obviously be working on another short-term assignments. Then there are always business development works that are around there. So it is a challenge while being at client location, while being a full-time resource, you are supposed to work on different assignments. So it is just that how you are managing it. So it's a challenge in itself, but then this is how you grow in a consulting world. See, so we all need to have those nerves which are required to, you know, excel in this consulting world. So besides that, as Jitendra sir also says, that you need to have that sales skills, because while you are in consulting world and to be able to grow in consulting world, you need to pursue that sales skill. You need to have that listening, networking skills with people, with government clients, with various other clients, internal clients, so that you will be able to, you know, kind of give your good performance there. So these are one, two areas, obviously challenging, but then I would again say that they are the road to actual growth in consulting world. Thank you.
Now my specific question to Arnav, when you talk about impact, obviously after a particular assignment, after completion or midway, people want to see some kind of changes or similar kind of thing.
Can you allow me? If you can take up the next question to somebody else, just allow me a couple of minutes, I'll get back to you.
Then my question is meant to Sika.
Okay.
How do you differentiate impact in development consulting scenario and in general, as a generalist context? Suppose in while our students take up initial assignments, then what kind of impact do you need on in development consulting? Do you feel any differentiation is there?
Sir, please correct me if I understand your question.
Yes.
Sir, you are asking me about that, how people can create impact in development sector or consulting firm or the other like other works which we do, like in SRLM and other projects.
That's true. My question is something different. I'm saying when a professor is given a particular kind of assignment, what kind of impact we generate in development consulting, and that kind of impact we cannot immediately expect from the professor. That's what I'm saying. How do we differentiate both the things? And how do we suggest our students to prepare from the immediate level of impact and of impact in the longer run? That's my question.
Okay, sir. Yes. So, sir, I would like to start like this. When any fresher join any organization or any company, so first of all, in my point of view, you should understand the structure of the company or the structure of your working place. Because, you know, it's a very necessary to create, if you want to do something, you should work as a team. And the second thing which I want to point here, that the first, along with your team members, you should also, you should know about your boss. Because in government sector, the bosses are like IAS officers. And it is a very different when we speak to any IAS in NIID, and when we speak at our workplace, because it's create a huge difference. Because there in NIIT, we are interacting as a student. That is a different scenario. And when we are interacting them as a workers or the employees, that is a different scenario. And in public sector, I would say it's a bit difficult to create an impact, because you know when you were in job, when I do few of my projects, it's up to the client whether they will improve those reports or not. From our part, we can do studies at ground level, and we can report them, sir. These are the actual situations on the ground. The other things they have to be keep in mind, like the financial aspects are there, then the other team things are there. So like in consulting firm, the every step, whatever they do, they have to consult with the seniors.
No, I got your point, but entire consulting is not revolving around study or research. I'm suggesting some consulting is statewide related to field implementation kind of thing. In that case, what kind of things you expect? This is the trend setter for the impact.
Okay. So that's, one thing I would like to just intervene here, Gyan, if I can understand or understood your question very well. So impact can be seen at the two level, if a new or the fresher is joining to organization, how is creating impact in that organization itself, or how is creating impact in the society. So like in the organization, if you wanted to say, like they can always contribute. Our example, or Abhishek, if I am correct, Abhishek's example is very handy, I will say here. So he joined organization as a, you know, like the new recruit or something like that. He presented those skills, like within a 3 months he got a very, you know, full-time employee, and now he is handling assignments of 2 members team. So this is the impact you can see within organization he created. But and the second question, if the second part of your question is the impact on the society, so I will say consultancy is one such job. If you want to really create impact, for example, I am presently handling one assignment, Uttar Pradesh SIDBI project management unit. So this is my responsibility to provide inputs for the state policy. So many MSME related policies which are coming up, I am providing certain inputs that will be incorporated in those schemes. I used to study the best practices among the 10 or other states, international best practices. I put them and align to the present policy where they can be incorporated. Once those policies are implemented at Uttar Pradesh, so definitely this is, as a consultant, our contribution to the society at large. And mostly impact are seen only after 3 to 4 years or the 5 years. Impact is such a word. So if you are mentioning for a fresher, so I will say he can see himself contributing to the larger pool of development, whether within a firm or any societal level. So there is huge potential in the consultancy for the creating larger impact. Yes.
It's a good thing. I think now the session is open for our students. My dear fellow friends, you may ask questions because I think today's development scenario, the relevant kind of things already we have discussed. Our distinguished panelists also throw light on important aspects of development consulting. Now the session is open, and by the end of the session, collating the entire things, and we'll have it for the discussion also. Please. Any question?
40 लोग दिखाई दे रहे हैं, 4 क्वेश्चन तो आने चाहिए, हमने अभी इतना ज्यादा.
हेलो,
गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, माय नेम इज जसपाल पटेल, आई एम फ्रॉम बेस्ट 2 पीजीडीएम आरएम. सर, आई हैव वन क्वेश्चन. नाउ करंटली आई एम वर्किंग इन एमपीएस आरआरएम, एंड सर कैन यू प्लीज एलाबोरेट व्हाट वी नीड टू लर्न फ्रॉम हियर एंड व्हाट शुड बी माय शॉर्ट टर्म गोल व्हिच विल हेल्प इन माय फ्यूचर सर.
So, shall I answer? Arnav, Abhishek, anybody would like to go ahead?
Abhishek.
Hello.
Yeah, Abhishek.
Yes, please. Abhishek.
So, I think there is some network connectivity issue on my side.
Okay.
So, Jiten, okay, sir, you can.
I will take up. Okay. See, once you are working with the SRLM, you are sitting in a gold mine because SRLM provides you multiple opportunities. If I just name financial inclusion, the livelihood project, skill development initiatives, and many much more sector. So the one thing, this is, I will say, the cheat sheet. So if you are working in the SRLM or your friends are working with the SRLM. So whatever your friends are working and they are learning, they are doing, you interact with them, all that experience becomes yours. Put all those things in your CV, very first thing. Second thing is that, see, when you see your current SRLM also hires consultants in different sectors. So, and they have put out RFPs, EOIs, study them. Because in those RFPs, they mention what type of functions are required and to be completed by those firms. So whether those skill sets are with you or not, if you don't have that thing, get first-hand experience or connect with those individuals who have that experience. Learn those things, put in your CV. So CV reflects your capabilities. And when you interact with your seniors or the hiring person from any consultants and firm, you should be able to elaborate or articulate that thing. You should be present in a storyline. If given the opportunity, you will be implementing these tasks in this manner, and this type of impact can be generated. Always quantify your things. Say within a 3 months, I will be doing 10 job melas, providing the placement to 8,000 in 10 sectors, 25 agencies or the employers. So quantify your things, qualitative things, put in your CV and interact. Always interact with your the fellow persons who are working in the consultancy firm. Within a SRLM, if they are other consultancy firm, they are working, observe, interact with them. And as I mentioned earlier, place your CV with those organizations. Hope I answered your question.
Okay, sir. Yes, got it.
Now, Ritulaj from Dash 12 is asking, what is the minimum experience required for joining in consulting firms? Anybody can pick.
Who has asked this question?
Yes, Ritulaj from Dash 12.
Okay, so probably you missed our conversation at very starting level. So Shikha has mentioned like a few of our consultancy firm is starting and hiring the freshers as well. But most of the time to get an established job, it requires minimum 2 years of experience. 1 to 2, like one I can say, but it is not like that. I cannot substantiate. But 2 years experience is required. And then it goes to 5 years, 10 years as experience increases. Your potential of getting hired as well as the higher salary is also there.
Yes, good. Satish, your question is how to get clients. Can you please unmute and speak? Because this one is not understood clearly. How to get clients? What does it mean exactly?
Firstly, hello everyone. Imagine I have just opened a consulting firm where we can work for the rural kind of activities or any other things like district administrations or legislative or executive. How to get those clients? How to get the first networking? Can someone enlighten?
Okay. See, today's discussion is something otherwise.
No, but I will also answer that question in a few sentences. See, there is a book from Alan Pease, like he says about the sales marketing. So all this starts with the cold call. If you wanted to go, and the direct question is how to get clients, take any state governments, dig darsika, jisme wo sare hote hain, used to call those directors of different sectors, say the animal husbandry and others, and just understand. And of course, before calling to them, you just see their yearly annual reports, what they are doing and how they are performing. You just call them, you explain, this is my expertise. If you provide a certain assignment to us, we can improve upon your performance, which is mentioned in your annual reports. I will just reiterate my points. See, getting clients is just like selling your product. Here, your product is the services which you are providing, and you should be knowing your services. You should be knowing yourself better, and you should be selling it out. Now, who is your buyer? To understand the buyer, you are seeing those individuals, those organizations which are lacking the things which you have. And then you are connecting with them. And if you have like If you are having some network from your father's side, father is the government officer, he can connect you with some of the officers. If you are having political connect, then you can directly go to meet 3 or 4 IAS officers and ask them, sir, do you have any this type of requirement? We can provide the services. So all the sales skills, and of course, that can be discussed, say the 10 minutes and the 20 minutes to answer your question elaborately. Feel free to call. Yeah.
Thanks. Any other question? The entire discussion is it? It's two things is we are either no one is listening attentively or you are not interested. Please come up.
Or the Sunday evening.
Sir, hello. Sir, actually, I got a few questions personally. The first question, one of my friend is asking, when you joined any organization, like a big organization, KPMG, EY, PwC, or GT, so how you have to maintain your confidence? Because sometimes it happens as you enter in an office. It's a very different scenario there. That you're from rural development to corporate sector, it's a big change. So how to deal stress at that time?
To start,
there are two things to success in consulting. Number one, your domain expertise, domain knowledge. And of course, the technical sales should be there. That's a hygiene factor. And apart from that, if you are working with clients, directly handling clients, then the respect you get from clients. These two things, if they are there, sab har koi respect karega aapko aur har koi matlab wo nervousness kabhi rahega nahi consulting industry mein.
Yeah, so I take this question, Shikha, a bit differently, because this question is less of, I will say, the development sector related or consultancy firm. This is a more related to how to tune with the new organization you are joining. So I would like to suggest any friend, colleague, the same answer here, not the answer, or my viewpoint will be like this. Please talk with some colleague, some teammates with similar experience, or like what they have done, what type of scenario can be there when tomorrow you are going to face your senior, you are going to face like your teammates. So the jo kehte na ke apne aap ko comfort feel karne ki sabse achhi jo cheez yahi hoti hai. Please have a open discussion with your teammates, some seniors. And that will definitely help. यार ये सारे सब चीज होती है ना, कुछ बहुत ज्यादा हमारे दिमाग का ही कुछ क्रिएट की हुई होती है इनिशियल स्टेज पे. वाकई ऐसा कुछ नहीं होता है. एंड ऑलवेज रिमेंबर, लाइक दिस इज माई पर्सनल लाइफ व्यू पॉइंट, अदर पर्सन दे आर देयर टू अप्रिसिएट यू, दे आर नॉट देयर टू फाइंडिंग फॉल्ट इन यू. ऑलवेज हैव दैट पॉजिटिव ओरिएंटेशन. सो इफ यू आर पुटिंग द राइट फुट फॉरवर्ड, दे विल readily accept you, they will encourage you, and be cheerful, give smiles, and everyone will welcome you. Yes,
thank you.
One more question I have, is there any certifications which we can do to be in consulting, you mean to be in consulting field for our progress?
Certification for what?
The certifications, like international certification where we have a recognition kind of those things. I think my friend is asking about like certifications like PMP, PRINCE2, all those things.
Yeah.
See, all those certifications are required for specific client request. They are not as general required for any particular assignment or for the success as a consultant in the field. Those experience will definitely help any individual in developing his, you know, the work style and how to deliver the task given and how to do the assignment, like we say, the scope of work and project deliverables. They can be indirectly helpful, indirectly as well as the directly. But for getting the job, they are not the prerequisites. But what are the prerequisites? If you wanted to work in the environment sector, of course, there can be 6 month or 1 year course. So going back one step back to my whatever I'm mentioning here, first understand what are the core areas you want to work upon. So if you want to go in the environment sector, you want to go in the urban development area or educational field, in that scenario, any course provided by the IGNOU or any such other distance course will be added advantage. But they are not prerequisite in general per se. Only client-to-client basis, they are required. Or any professional course such as PMP, they are helpful in developing your own way of working, handling things, handling that given task. Yes, please.
Any other question?
I have a question.
Yes.
I would like to know, like, how many years did it take for you to find, like, your domain in, like, I'm not just asking consultations or consultancies. Like, I'm working since last 4 years, but I'm still, like, trying to find my right domain in rural development. Like, there's so many sectors, IB or institutional builders or capacity building. Does it take, like, how was it for you?
Yes. Four of you. It's a great question. Any other panelists?
See, Jana, like for me, it is, I will say, the arranged marriage type wala situation mere liye is tarah se ho jata hai because my elective was skill development. My first job was at NIRD with the skill development, and then everybody is hired me on the skill development itself. So for me, it was inbuilt from the PGDRDM itself, and like they have seen there itself. So it was not something like I worked for 3-4 years, then decided. It was by default for me. Yeah, please.
This one, I would like to add one thing. What Jitendra is saying, it is perfectly said. It's an inbuilt kind of thing. When you take off these assignments, obviously, you will have a feeling that I have some sort of inclination towards a particular arena, be it financial inclusion, it's livelihood one or any social kind of things or skill. That is, you will be, when I have some feeling, you are inclined towards a particular kind of thing. And I think that from your heart, you should come up and take that particular assignment to pursue as a career. Yes, any question?
Jana, sometimes it's a very great that you work in a different sectors. You know, if I tell about myself, I have worked in skill development, I worked in MSME sector, then I also got a chance to work in urban development where we don't have anything. But you know, when I was there in urban development, I got to learn new things. So I think it's a great to have an experience of a different sectors or a different verticals. Now I can say I have an experience of a rural development. I have experience of a urban development as well.
Yeah, that's so, very well said, Shikha.
Yes,
continue.
So it's a great, at least you are lucky that you are working only, you are working in a, on the verticals which are related to rural development only. It's not like that for three months or some, you have worked in rural development, then again you shift to your project, which is a totally different. So even in a rural development, if you are working in a, like a capacity building, then kind of in a field, I mean, like a field visits, it's a great thing. It will give you the advantages when you will approach other companies or when you will, you would like to switch somewhere else.
Okay. It's true. Yes. Yes. Anyone?
So that's very true, rightly said by Shikha and Jitendra sir and Arunam sir. So while in a consulting world, that is also the grim realities that you get to work on different domains, and you should actually not limit yourself. So Jitendra sir would he would appreciate the fact that he would always look for a senior consultant who is working in various domains. Because then he would be requiring someone who can actually take up assignments from various clients, who is open to various clients. So it is always advisable in a consulting world that you work on different domains, and then that is how you learn actually in consulting world also. So that's very true in that sense.
Yes, Abhishek. Anyone question?
No, the one thing I would like to add, Jaina's, for understanding. See, even if we becomes, we develop expertise of one sector, but I will just mention here and mind and would like everybody to be cautious in the consultancy world. Once you become a consultant, that expertise dilutes. Like, it is expected by your seniors that you should be able to put yourself in other shoes. Like, they expect me to write some business proposal for the infrastructure project. They will also like me to contribute something on the sports related things. So after certain times working in a consultancy firm, you develop one way of working or way of approaching things. So that expertise you can get in few months, like for the Jaina mentioned, 3-4 years it takes and you feel you are expert. But once you are working in the consultancy field, you are established. After 3-4 years, you will be capable to jump on different sectors and develop expertise in very brief period. So that's to add on thing. I just noticed one question here. What is your views on fellowship and how can it add value to your career? This is again related to the previous question asked by the Shikha, how PMP or other program can help in getting the job. So as far as I have seen, very few client ask at initial stage any fellowship related degree. But fellowship related work develops your expertise of any area. So whenever you join a firm, your CVs are given more weight. And when you perform well, your growth within a firm or within an organization will be faster. So fellowship can help you in developing that technical expertise. But getting a job, or I will say maintaining a job, those things are not related whether you are having a fellowship or not. Of course, knowledge definitely helps. Yeah, next question, please.
Next question. So actually, if we go to call day, I think we discuss on important aspects like what our esteemed speakers highlighted upon. Three, four things that clearly emerge out of our discussion. When you talk about this development consulting, obviously it's the domain is wide open, and basically it's public sector and private sector kind of things. The focus would be on PAF. Second, as a young man, as a new assignment holder, or as a new entrant into this arena, you need to make yourself a domain expert to a particular kind of thing. Then there should be some minimum skill set which are required to enter upon this kind of assignments. And the key, the entire focus was on the soft skill, basically the interpersonal relationship and your confidence building, minimum level of confidence, and your confidence building measures also, because you'll be encountering some issues like there will be some n number of problems in consulting, then obviously you would be formulating strategies to overcome this kind of things. Then one great question was regarding how to engage with the client, how to come with new assignment kind of things. And I think these are the kind of things we highlighted often. And I think if any other question is there, otherwise I will be focusing, I will be taking your 5 minutes time to speak my point of view here. Expecting questions within 1 to 2 minutes, otherwise I think we are at the verge of finish. Any question?
Sir, when you get a call from any consulting firm, sir, how much time it takes to finally get on board?
For me, it's minimum 3 months.
So for PwC, it's also a kind of 2 to 3 months, because you can understand the process is very rigorous now. So while trying to onboard you, we'll have to undertake you through a background check verification process, which usually takes 1 to 1.5 months. And so you can take it around 2 months for onboarding.
That means you are under the process to hire Sikha. The underlying message is here.
Okay, same in EY as well. 2.5, 3 months.
3 months, minimum.
Well, for me, it took 5 months.
Okay. It varies.
So my first interview was in November. Then they called me in mid of March for the final round.
For me, see, I think now I think you will be winding up this session, and before I know, I will be throwing some lights on some important aspects. My dear friends, what kind of consulting or development consulting we are talking upon, the entire discussion and deliberation, we focus upon this development consulting thing. But my point is here, the entire kind of consulting that emerges from sustainable development goal set by UNDP. There are 17 number of goals. When a particular fellow enters into this kind of consulting, he will be finding poverty is one of the domains. Education is there, health is there, then your industry is also there, infrastructure kind of thing is there. You will be finding environment as an assignment, you will be finding clean water, green energy. Entire kind of consulting, you will be deriving the from entire things from UNDP strategy paper. And I would like to request my friends to go India strategy paper 2020 to 2025. They have formulated a good strategy paper. Our consultants or students, anybody can go through it. I think when you talk about this consulting, that freshers basically who will be joining with SRLMs or NGOs, see the localized context of development. You need to scan the entire environment, what kind of interventions is needed, and what kind of strategies we formulate. I am not saying it's a broad strategy. You need to formulate and that to be acted upon in the national or state context. But at least in a localized scenario, in a block, in a district, wherever you are working, at least scan the environment properly and formulate some strategies that is fit into the arena of their kind of things. And the second major aspect is wherever you are working, expertise, making yourself expert on particular kind of things. I'm not saying it's domain expertise on X number of domain, but I'm saying when you're talking about basically assignment to the SRLM talks about financial inclusion, livelihood kind of things, then social development is there, you'll be finding skill development there. But wherever it was, please go deep into the entire aspect. Until unless you deep dive, then if you are just coordinating with some of the departments, you will be doing superficial kind of things. Then at the end of the assignment, by the end of 3 years, you will get missed. Because my personal experience is many of the young professionals, after completing their 2 to 3 year of tenure, they are getting jobless. Because of this kind of scenario, suppose you will be doing just coordinating with departments, writing letters, won't be going into deep into the subject, then by the end of the day, you will be losing. So wherever you are, just connect with our NIRD assignments. I will be congratulating Murli sir, putting his focus, and the way Sir has been articulating the things the way he has been guiding our students. I think we need to connect our base with our assignment. Always you will be finding focus on kind of things. Articulation is the key, because at least we should write one paragraph and try to put in Abhivakti and other things, and that will be rectified by your seniors, and the entire focus will be to groom because the good grooming, I think, is the key. Whenever your boss is good, whenever your immediate senior is good, you will be getting chance, you will be getting opportunity to learn many more things. But my personal sincere request, don't involve in smallest when silly kind of matters, office politics kind of thing, and that will spoil your initial career. And if you lost your energy in your initial days, then obviously you will be losing, and it would be very difficult for you to get into development consulting kind of thing. Because development consulting, when you talk about, is the second line of assignment. First, when you are doing your things at a particular level, you will be finding this is a graduation kind of things. And obviously, in your initial days, try to focus on your particular area. And my sincere request would be two things I will be focusing. First, try to focus upon your subject, try to focus upon your assignments, and try to bring as much as quality of that particular assignment while talking about. I asked one point on impact, because when we talking about impact in our job scenario, I am not saying impact in different levels, you will be observing different kind of things. That means by the end of the assignment, you will be finding an immediate impact. A certain number of people will be engaged, certain number of income generation is there. People will be expecting what is the incremental income to the entire livelihood kind of things if you are intervening. So my sincere request would be to focus upon these kind of things. And if there is, I think, no more question at this context, then I would be requesting to Jaina to present both of them.
Yes, thank you so much. Yes. So all of you, thank you so much for being here. We were expecting a webinar like this so that so many of us were asking what to do next, including myself. And thank you so much, Jitender and Arnab, Shikha, and Jana, sir. Thank you so much for the moderation. You were able to pull it out and ask more questions that we were unable to maybe ask or think about, since we are still working and there's a lot more to do in the future. And this is to all the others who are right now, your videos are off and we can't see you. If you want to ask any questions, please post in the WhatsApp group. And for the coming webinars, if you want any particular topic to be spoken about or to have a session, you're most welcome to write us on mails in Abhivyakti, abhivyakti.nard@gmail.com. I would put the email ID in the WhatsApp group and as well here in the chat as well. So thank you so much and have a nice day. It's a Sunday, I know. Please go and enjoy yourself. And thank you all. Thank you so much. Yes. And thank you, Abhivyakti team, for putting this forward. Yeah. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you, everyone, for having us. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you,
everyone.
Thank you, everyone.
Good night.
Thank you.
Yeah, Karthik sir, you're the host. You have to.